Tomasz Adamek and Vinny Matalone, our main event, coming up next here in Newark, New Jersey. Adamek's fifth heavyweight bout. After he had title belts in lower weight classes, he has set up a home here in Newark.
And he's back to place again.
If they said Adamek versus TBA,
it would be a sellout. It's good to see a lot of people come out in Newark. I used to, believe it or not, I used to work not too far from here on a newspaper which doesn't exist anymore. Which we know about that. But
yes, we do. And Newark comes out for the fights.
Put on a good fight with a good athlete. People want to watch
it. All right, boxing fans.
We have a tradition in the sport of boxing, and that tradition is that we will award a takedown
for those who are beloved in the world of boxing who we lose. And a beloved trainer, as a matter of fact, the trainer of Tomasz Adamek, Stanisław Orlicki, passed away on December 4th. So now, in honor of his memory, we'd ask for a moment of silence and a memorial 10 count. Thank you. Thank you. May Stanisław Orlicki rest in peace. And now, ladies and gentlemen, in honor of our main event, here with us this evening is international beauty pageant contestant and recording star to sing the national anthem of Poland, Iwana Chmielewska.
Jeszcze Polska nie zginęła, kiedy my żyjemy. Co nam obca przemoc wzięła, szablą odbierzemy. Marsz, marsz Dąbrowski, z ziemi włoskiej do Polski, za twoim
Now, ladies and gentlemen, to honor America, we are joined by a U.S. Coast Guard veteran and recording star whose CD, Chose to Fly, is an award winner. Here is Chief Petty Officer Christine Rommel with our national anthem.
Twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. Bursting in air, gave
for Christine Rommel, everybody.
Revitalized city, a lot to offer in the performing arts, athletics, so much going on. And tonight, major boxing has held center stage. You get the nighttime view, and inside an electrified Prudential Center, the joint is rocking tonight, folks, as Newark's favorite adopted son, Tomasz Adamek, inside the Prudential Center, will be taking on Vinny Matalone. Adamek, the pride of Poland, has obtained a fanatical following here. And Vinny Matalone from New York, straight ahead, tough brawler. What you see is what you get. Dave Bontempo and Tony Page with you.
Here's the tail of the tape. Adamek a little older, Matalone a little taller. Matalone with the big weight advantage, 13 and a half pounds, and the reach pretty much even. Matalone about an inch. Unified rules, no three knockdowns, no standing eight count. Fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round, and only the referee can stop the fight.
So the Rocky music blaring, pride of the underdog.
Can't go wrong with that kind of music.
And here's the guy to march in with it. Vinny Matalone, 33-6, 24 KOs in Queens. A lot of people looking past him, but he did lose a split decision to John Mormack in France, of France, on the road. So he's a guy that can rise up if he gets the right style and the right situation.
He had time to prepare for this one. 24 knockouts in his 33 victory. You're not going to have to look for Vinny. He'll be right in front of you.
Said in a training camp of 14 weeks because he was expecting another fight to happen. And when that fell out, he just kept training. And the Adamek fight came along. No pressure on Vinny Matalone.
No.
There's his promoter, Joe DeGuardia. Steve Smoger, the referee.
Be interesting to see right off the bat what happens. Did it go right to the center of the ring and start winging? Or is it a feeling out process?
And like many heavyweights who have been in that division, they see a guy moving up.
Yeah.
They still have a sneaking suspicion underneath that they can make some noise.
Vinny's outweighing Tomas by 13 and a half pounds, but that's nothing new for Tomas. He was outweighed by 43 in his last fight in Michael Grant. He's always outweighed, but he's a scrapper. He comes to fight no matter how big or how strong the other guy is.
Well, in Matalone, Adamek will just be happy he doesn't have to climb a ladder to fight this guy, as he did against Michael Grant.
Former light heavyweight champion, former cruiserweight to center.
Last time here, outpointing Michael Grant. Time before that, outpointing Jason Estrada. Both of whom challenged him in that fight. And for Tomasz Adamek, it's fill up the joint, be an active fighter, cash in your opportunities. he's really come into his own in the last couple of years with Main Events.
And now he's working with Roger Bloodworth in his corner. Veteran trainer. Join his pack, Dave. Build up very quickly.
On a Thursday night. In the wee hours of the morning in Poland. A lot of people watching this too.
Ladies and gentlemen, Main Events, Ziggy Promotions, in association with Joe DeGuardia's Star Boxing, present 12 rounds of action for the IBF International and NABO Heavyweight Championships. Our judges overseeing this championship bout, Julie Letterman, Robin Taylor, Steve Weisfeld, and our referee at the bell, Steve Smoker. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He comes to us tonight from Queens in New York City. He weighed in at 230 pounds. Silver trunks, black trim, excellent professional record. 33 wins, only 6 losses, and 24 big knockouts. Please welcome Vinny Metalone! And his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. Originally, he hails from Gliwice, Poland. He now fights out of Jersey City, New Jersey. Black trunks, orange trim. Professional record, 42 victories, only 1 defeat, and 27 big knockouts. He is the reigning and defending IBF International and NABO Heavyweight Champion. Please welcome Tomas Goro Adames.
Steve Smoker will get thin it down. While we get this moment, we want to wish our continued good wishes for the speedy recovery of our buddy.
Smoker has our fighters' final instructions.
We'll get to it in a second.
Your instructions in your respective dressing rooms. Please obey my commands, respect the bell, and above all, protect yourself at all times. Touch gloves. God bless you both.
All right, so the stare down goes nowhere. So it's Adamek and Matalone. They're clearing the ring. They're also making sure the photographers are not underneath.
And make sure Steve Weisfeld, the judge over there, can see what he's doing.
That's a sign of some old-time boxing. All the media jamming around ringside. And here we go. Adamek and Matalone.
See if Vinny tried to just steamroll him right off the bat, use his power, or does he try and set him up? Tomas Adamek just looking to see if he can use the jab, drop a right hand, see what happens early.
So is it going to be Matalone that's done well in other fights, or is it going to be like a Galata reincarnation, which was an early knockout for Adamek? Adamek and Matalone, part of a series here called Brick City Boxing. They're bringing old-time boxing back to Newark at every 3 months or so, with ticket sellers and names like Adamek, and building from the grassroots. So Main Events has been doing that here, and Adamic has been the star of that.
Back in 07, Madelon had a big fight against a big name in Evander Holyfield, got stopped early. It was a while ago. Opens up a little bit on Madelon.
Let's see what kind of shape Madelon can get out of a 14-week training camp. Meanwhile, for Adamic, you figure the usual quick start. And the question is it going to be a bang-a-thon in the middle of the ring, or will he use the angles that he can use and make Madelon off balance?
I think Adamic is going to use his speed a little bit. I think he's starting to even, you know, feel a little comfortable right off the bat. He knows he can outspeed him, so now he's going to use his speed to get, plant his punches.
Keep rolling out. Keep rolling out.
These shots here from Adamic to the body.
The question now is, nice left hook. The question is, whose chin holds up under a good shot?
And will Madelon cut?
Yes. A lot of cuts in his career.
And especially somebody with the speed of Adamic and the slashing ability, that cut is a realistic scenario here.
Vinny told us the other day, yesterday that when he goes to Europe, you've got to score a knockout to win. I asked him, does he need a knockout here to win, being that this is Adamic's hometown, so to speak? He said no, but I think he might have wanted to press the action a little bit.
It's not Poland, but it could be.
Yeah.
Just listen to this crowd. I mean, it's a happening for Adamic, no matter who he's fighting. Good sized crowd here, just 16 days before Christmas, as we come to the end of round one.
Madelon likes to come forward. He also tries to load up on his punches. Wild looping right.
All right, Roger.
Adamic makes him pay with a nice little flurry.
We start round two. Tomas Adamic and Vinny Madelon here in North. Dave Bontempo and Tony Page with you. Adamic 42-1, 27 knockouts. Madelon 33-6, 24 knockouts. We saw a little bit of both scenarios, styles from Adamic in the first round. Tony, we saw some of the movement. We also saw him banging the body.
Yeah, I think he's just trying to set him up with the movement, make him move around, maybe tire him out a little bit, make him do something he's not used to doing. I think Vinny figured they'd stay in a certain round and slug, but Tomas is a little smarter than that. He's going to use his angles, going to use his footwork, going to use his speed. Nice shots by Adamic. Nice jab.
That was a good right hand behind the jab for Adamic. Madelon coming back with his right hand.
Madelon's just walking forward. He needs to jab his way in. I know he's trying to cut the ring off on him, but he's got to use the jab also.
It's the speed of Adamic versus can Madelon catch him and put himself in a good situation. Good hand speed there from Adamic. One of the things I've loved that he does, Tony, is you can come at him and load up a punch, and he'll take a quick little shuffle step and keep his offensive position, and then he'll throw his punches.
Yeah, some guys go too far, and I call it resetting, but they reset too far outside. He's just like going around the edges of Vinny Madelon, just staying in his own punching range. He's not taking himself out of punching range.
body shot here from Adamic. And a good right hand.
And that's what Madelon has to do. He has to throw volumes of punches. And maybe that's not his style, but you're going to have to slow down Adamic at some point. You can't stay outside and come walking all the way in and give Adamic a chance to do that, land 3, 4, 5 punches real quick.
Good hand speed for Adamic here and the use of angles. And the confidence to stand in semi-brawl when necessary. Good jab here by Adamic. We have seen him progress through his heavyweight fights, try to learn something from each one.
I like what Adamic is doing. He goes up top, and Madelon tries to block it. Then he goes down to the body, so whatever's open, he's trying to take.
And a little action here from Madelon as he tries some wide-angle shots.
Adamic has good hand speed in this round. There you see him, nice combination. Looks for the opening. Vinny coming ahead slowly. 1, 2, 3, 4. He waits for Vinny to bounce back and come forward. He's ready to throw again. Good round for Adamic. Adamic.
And we start round 3. Tomas Adamic, Vinny Madelon here at the Prudential Center in North New Jersey. Before we go too far, we want to wish along our best wishes for a continued speedy recovery for the legendary Colonel, the great Bob Sheridan, recuperating in Las Vegas from illness. We're happy about the continued comeback trail. So, Colonel, get back out here. There's a shortage of laughter with you not being out here.
Absolutely.
Dave Bontempo and Tony Page with you here from the Prudential Center. Tomas Adamic off to a quick start here against Vinny Madelon.
Madelon better pick up the pace a little bit, because he could just lose round after round at this rate. He's got to be offensive. He's got to jump in his face and throw some solid, hard punches.
The right hand from Adamic. Good right hand from Adamic, and Madelon walked right into it.
Yep.
Adamic's smart enough, Tony, to take what you give him.
Yep, he'll go to the body, he'll go to the head. His confidence is growing too. His speed is there. Good body shots right there. Madelon covers the head, he goes downstairs. Covers downstairs, he goes back upstairs. He just won't let Madelon get set to throw a hard punch. See, this is where he's got to let go.
We've seen the growth of Adamic as a heavyweight, especially early in all of his fights, showing a little bit more muscle, a little bit more speed. The question will come at the end of the fight. That's been the toughest transition for him. Later rounds, wearing down.
Adamic ran with some good shots right on the chin of Madelon.
Body shots here from Adamic. Adamic again working the body. Good uppercut by Adamic. Surprised Madelon a little bit. Madelon back with an uppercut. Madelon not even jabbing his way in here.
No, just walking in head first, and you're giving Adamic a chance just to throw punches and build up points. Throw the jab right behind it.
Yeah. Good angle taken here by Adamek, and a nice left hook to the body.
10 seconds.
So round three, like the previous two, a good one for Tomasz Adamek.
Adamek taking whatever available. They see Madelon coming up to the body. He goes down, coming to the head, goes to the body, then goes up top to the head after he covers up the body.
So good sequence for Adamek as we go into round four. Tomasz Adamek from Poland has been put a lot of seats in, filled up here at the Prudential Center. Vinny Madelon from Queens, New York, with an uphill battle against him.
You wonder if Madelon's gonna get a little frustrated now because he's just not throwing any punches, he's just taking them right now.
Looks a little gassed.
Yep, yep.
And there's
good
a big
shot.
Right hand from Adamek, and Madelon getting rocked by that.
He's just throwing wild punches. Adamek's just gotta keep his punches straight. Don't get wild with it.
Madelon trying to load up. Crowd sensing something big here.
Good body shot. Go to the body first, try and keep softening him up.
The thing you have to love about Adamek is the absence of wasted punches.
No, you're absolutely right. Doesn't bring the punches back too far, no looping shots, just straight from the shoulder.
A lot of parallels in how Evander Holyfield was moved years ago, coming up and then through the cruiserweight, light heavyweight ranks and actually becoming a heavyweight champion. That is what they're trying to do with Adamek, get a meaningful fight for him, build his fan base. And he's been the most active heavyweight among the noted names in all of boxing. And some very good fights for him this year. The one with Chris Arriola was an excellent one back in April.
And he might not have been the favorite going into that. Arriola was getting the big buildup.
Yeah, it was on Arriola's turf, too.
Yeah.
That showed a lot. That was a tough, grueling triumph for him.
Arriola's a tough fighter, but be curious to see if Adamek is going for the knockout. And he's doing the work that goes unnoticed. You go to the body, a couple of shots to the head, try and soften him up, just take your time. It takes rounds, and a lot of fighters get impatient. Oh, I got to knock him out in 2-3 rounds. No, sometimes it just takes a while.
Vinny Madelon looking all of 36 in this fight. It's a fast pace. Set by a lighter man who's pretty strong too. As Tomasz Adamek, as is his fashion, continues to build up early rounds.
Good. He's not ready to go yet. If you hit it in your hurry, that was good. Go ahead and follow up. Keep boxing.
Adame taking deep breaths because why he's been busy. A lot of punches. Punches and bunches, as they say. All headshots. Nice right hand. Got Madelone on the defensive. Another time, just open up a good body shot there to set up the shots to the head. Nice flurry by Adame. Nothing back for Madelone.
And into round five we go.
I got a shutout so far, Dave, 40-36, third of the way through.
Good work for Tomas Adamek, who is setting the pace of a light heavyweight in a heavyweight contest here against Vinny Madelone. I think that's one thing that's bothered Madelone is the speed at which this fight is being contested.
I think he figured, you know, maybe Adame would try and take him out and they'd be in the center of the ring banging. But Adame is showing something. Very smart, takes his time. As you said, he conserves his punches. But when they do come in bunches, they all seem to land.
Yeah, the jab and then the hook to the body. He's a guy who's willing to do the work, whether he knocks out his opponent or not.
And, you know, to knock a guy out late in the round, you know, it takes time. It takes a game plan. You have to stick to it. It's not very pretty. It's easy for the first round knockout. It's, you know, not that much work. You catch a guy, it's over. But when a guy has a good chin, is a good fighter, you have to take your time. You have to lay the groundwork to stop him late.
He walked into trouble.
Picks a perfect shot.
That's speed creating power.
Yes.
Now Adamek could finish the show here. Madelone is in deep trouble. Steve Smolder is a fighter's referee, but he won't let Madelone take more than is necessary.
I think an uppercut could end this the way Vinny's leaning forward just a little bit.
Explosiveness here from Adamek. Madelone,
nice shot.
On borrowed time.
Oh, that's a good shot right there.
Can't take
timer.
Much more of this.
I would stop it. I think he's on the verge. A couple more shots.
Smolder's taking a close look in the corner.
The corner's trying to stop it. The corner's trying to stop it, and even Adamek. Look at that. He's wobbling back. Yep. Good job by the corner. Even Tomas Adamek said, look at him. Look at him. Look at the corner.
A timely stoppage. Referee was looking it over, close to making a call, and the corner makes it for him. And Tomas Adamek, speed equals power. Regardless of whatever people thought of Vinny Madelone coming in, that is Adamek's most definitive power work against a bigger guy since he became a heavyweight. That was the speed of a lighter fighter and the strength of a heavyweight. Vinny Madelone never really was able to get himself into this fight. Talked earlier that Adamek will pay the price, won't waste the punches, he'll work. If it's a decision, fine. A lot of his recent fights have been decisions. This time, he gets the stoppage. An infinite difference in the speed of these two fighters. Let's get the final numbers.
Boxing fans, the time, 2:17 of round number five. Your referee, Steve Smolder, calls a halt to the contest. Your winner by technical knockout, Tomas Gora Adamek.
And the celebration has begun, not only here in Newark, but all across Poland at daybreak. And when we take a look at the replays, watch the leverage, watch the hips, and then watch the hand speed. Look at that adjustment. He's moving back, but he sees the opportunity. Matlow's coming forward. Adamek does that as he's backing up. That's really impressive. Sees the opportunity, and then he finishes it off. It's very hard when you see a chance and you're backing up to put your opponent on your back. Now, Steve Smoker is close to calling this here. You see that Matalone is gassed, and the corner actually makes this call. Adamek tells him, look at the corner. And that's a compassionate corner doing their job for their fighter. All right, Tony Page is standing by with Tomasz Adamek. Take it away, Tony.
Thanks very much, Dave. I'm here with Tomasz. Great performance. It seems like you took your time. You had a game plan. What was it?
You know, when we started the fight, it was punch to punch, you know, very, very difficult opponent. So everybody, how is Vinny Matalone? He's a warrior and not afraid of nobody. You know, he's a good punch. But, you know, I'm smartest, I'm stronger.
You used your speed. All your punches were conservative. You didn't waste a lot of energy. Was that part of the game plan going against him?
Rajan, before fight said, you have to be fast. Fast is power. That's it.
Your speed created the power in this fight.
Yeah, speed is power. Speed is power. That's it.
When you had him hurt, the corner was trying to stop it. You stepped back and told the referee, take a look at the corner.
Because I saw him, you know, he was no good, you know. I shoot, referee should maybe stop early, but, you know, this is boss on the ring.
What would you give yourself? How do you like your performance tonight?
You know, how I like?
Jakbyś sobie ocenę dał za te...
You know, I made everything what Raju said. I movements side to side. I was fast. That's it.
Did he hit you at all? Did he hurt you at all?
No. I'm not hit me.
What do you want to do next?
This is behind me is boss.
Well, Ziggy, what do we do next?
I don't know. We're going to see the best offer. So whoever gives us... I mean, we're looking for Klitschko's and we're looking for...
David Hay.
And if we don't get them, then we find somebody else.
You got a big crowd tonight. Everybody got to see you. What do you say to your fans?
You know, you see, I love everybody. Thank you very much. We came to my fight.
There you have it, Dave, a champion. Let's take a look at the knockout. Take us through it right here on the knockout. You set him up. You used your speed. You used your footwork. Then you had him all to yourself. Take us through it. Perfect shot?
Yeah, perfect, because, you know, he came to me because we saw his fight. Every time he going to me, but I have good defense. I like a defense fight, you know. I'm catching.
No, you were a light heavyweight. Where's the power coming from?
I'm mountain guy, mountain boy, you know. I born in my village. I'm tough and hard.
What do you have to say to the rest of the heavyweight champions out there?
Co ty byś powiedział resztę mistrzom świata?
You know, I will champion heavyweight, maybe next year. Only God know when.
There you go. We send it back down to ringside, Dave Bontempo.
Okay, thank you, Tony Page. And that is the message that Tomasz Adamek will send the heavyweights. Take a look at this fight. David Hay might be a realistic possibility for him in 2011. So the plans just become bigger. In the meantime, it's like you go to the dice tables, you cash in your chips, and you still have something left for the next time you come. You get a nice payday, you delight your fans, you get more people talking about you, and you entertain people. For Tomasz Adamek, this is the way he wanted to do it. Tony, not only did he get a victory tonight in a knockout, but he entertained.
He did. He brought a full house here, and he didn't disappoint. Used his speed, used his power. Nice performance by him.
Okay, so a lot of possibilities for him in 2011. All right, so great night here for Tomasz Adamek. And he concludes a very big year It was Chris Areola on the road in the gut check performance of victory. He scored a win here over Michael Grant back in the middle of the summertime in August. And here against Vinny Matalone, he takes care of business the way he was supposed to, on the front running end and getting the job done. Vinny Matalone coming in. Tomas Adamek, self-assured, comes up with a nice victory. Look at the hand speed. Too much for Vinny Matalone. And then the big combination as he was going back. Tomas Adamek, the most active heavyweight in boxing right now, and he continues to inject interest into the division, especially in the United States, where people want something to be excited about, and they've got this guy, and so does Poland. For Tony Page, for Frank Belmont, this is Dave Fontempo saying so long, everybody. See you next time.